This is the Chronoblob2 by All Right Devices. It is a digital delay module that can sync to a clock signal. When we connect a clock signal to the sync port, we can see that the indicator lights start flashing in time with the clock. Adjusting the time knob to the left will set the delay to a multiplication of the clock signal, and to the right will set the delay to a division of the clock signal. If there's no sync input, the knob will flow through a delay time from 5 milliseconds to 2.73 seconds. Here are some examples. Here it is with no delay, a completely dry signal. Here it is 50% wet signal and 1x set in the middle of the time knob. Here is divided by 3, with the time knob turned to the right. The main benefit of being able to sync to the clock is aligning the delay with tempo. Here's a drum beat as an example. When you adjust the time knob live, you will hear a pitch shift from a tape-style delay effect. This is what it sounds like. You can turn this off by flipping this switch to smooth fades, and now it sounds like this. The dry wet knob sets the output mix between the signal input and the delayed signals. Crank to the left will have no delay, and crank to the right will be fully wet. The feedback knob controls the amount of signal sent back through the delay. This knob goes over 100%. The black line shows 1 to 100% and the pink section shows 100 to 125%. The feedback level will snap to 100% if it's where the pink and black line meet. There's some wiggle here where you can move the knob but no change happens. This button will shut off the feedback audio inputs and activate an infinitely repeating loop. This port can take a control voltage to trigger the infinite loop. Above 0.7 volts triggers the function, and this is what it sounds like. The Chronoblob2 has 4 delay modes. Let's hear what they sound like on a slow C minor arpeggio. The dial settings across all the knobs will remain the same so that we can hear the differences. I'm going to set the right delay offset just slightly. I'm going to put it at plus 20. This first one is called dual delay. The next one is called ping pong. Second to last is called single. This last one is called cascade. When you're utilizing the blue modes, the right input and output become feedback send and return. The manual suggests using a low pass filter for a smooth echo. Let's see how that sounds. The manual also states a wave folder may get weird, as they put it. So let's see what that's like. This introduction is just scratching the surface on the possibilities of the Chronoblob2. Check this thing out on VCV Rack. It's free and you can get it by searching Chronoblob on the VCV library page or by subscribing to All Right Devices on the plugins page. That's all for now. If you have any questions, please post them in the comments. If you like this kind of content, you can let me know that by liking and subscribing. Catch you in the next one.